Hey, it's Mel from Rap Rankings. To hear the full episode this clip comes from and all of the other episodes, check the link in the description, stop by raprankings.com, or search Rap Rankings on your favorite podcast platform. And please consider liking, subscribing, and commenting to help us grow the channel and continue our journey as hip-hop's first and premier extreme podcast.
Track 7, Groupie Love, featuring Butch Cassidy, produced by Midi Mafia. Yeah, this song, 7 minus.
Flat 8. Ding Me Baby. It's my favorite song on the album.
Wow.
I'm utterly shocked this wasn't a single.
It was catchy.
In my mind. Like, it was on a lot of mixtapes, so it felt like a single. They played it on the radio quite a bit in New York, so it felt like a single. It was not one of the singles that was released. But okay. You know what? I know why. Because between the Butch Cassidy feature and the beat itself, which I think Midi Mafia are New Yorkers, but the beat sounds kind of Rick Rock-ish, like some of those Rick Rock beats from the Dynasty, Parking Lot Pimpin', I think, and a few others, that, you know, maybe it was like it sounded a little too regional. For my money, though, this is like the best song on here. I love how the Al Green sample blends with the Butch Cassidy background vocals. He's fucking great on here. 50 Cent's melodic stuff on here is great. His rapping's really fun. I like his tone a lot on this record. The chorus is very catchy. Yeah, this is just like, and Yayo's on this one. It's like, you know, it's the oasis of, you know, being in the desert with this young buck, just, you know, in your ear all day long. And then finally you see your friend, you know, and it's a perfect example of why this album needed more Yayo. His verse is great. Very, you know, crude, but hilarious as he's known to be. Mm-hmm. And, yeah, I really love like everything about this record. Banks still on his player shit. And we don't even have to hear Young Buck at all. It's like the ideal song on this album for me. It's got everything I like on it.
You know, this week was, this song was one of those classic, you know, week-long slow builds. And in the final hour, it went up because it was like, I think it was a flat 6. And then I was like, no, I like this beat, this quirky sounding beat, the stuttered vocal sample. It's a good beat. So I'm thinking, oh, it might be a 6+. And then the chorus started getting stuck in my head. I'm like, okay, definitely a 6+.
Yeah. Groupie and then love. I was just like, give me that groupie love. Exactly. Give me that groupie love. Okay. You see me? Give me that groupie love.
Shout out to this chorus. Shout out to Midi Mafia. 7 minus for sure. Here's the thing, because it started when he's like, you know, I've been so many places, seen so many faces, girl, you look like someone that I didn't fuck before. My thought is like, who is that for? Imagine like a woman hearing that. What are they supposed to do with that information? And then I was like, well, as a guy, I mean, this for me, Mel, this is something I'd play disillusioned leaving a party because it was like a bunch of vapid people throwing themselves at me because like I'm famous or something. So it has use, but I'm not in that situation in real life and don't imagine I'll be in that situation anytime soon. So I'm like, I don't know. I'm still a 6+ maybe. But then the music and the verses.
It's too musically connected. Good. The verses are too fun.
They're fittingly brash and flippant for the subject. It works. 7 minus, you know.
But there's like an underlying sweetness to all of it with that Al Green sample and the Butch Cassidy vocals. It's like all kind of tongue in cheek.
Yeah.
You know? I love everything about this record. Let's start with the sample. We have the sample. It starts like 2 minutes into the sample, so I clipped it. It's Al Green, Simply Beautiful, which I'm submitting as a potential money sample because I've heard it flip many times before. We'll play a bunch of those flips, and I think it always adds to the record. Like, it's not just a great song on its own. It doesn't just make a great sample because it's a great song. The way his vocals sound, Al Green has a very specific tone. The way it's like put into this record, like we'll hear when we play Groupie Love, how the vocals at the beginning, this, how it kind of builds with the beat. Very, this is like a particularly amazing flip of the Al Green song, but we'll go through all the flips and we'll start with the sample itself. So this is Simply Beautiful by Al Green.
All right. Yeah,
beautiful. Yeah, when you get right down to it. Oh.
Pardon me for this because I disgusted myself even thinking about it, but we're trying to expand the pocket and we're trying to get our numbers back up and appeal to the common denominator. So I'll just say it. Him singing, the way he sings sounds like when she giving you that hawk Tuah. Right?
No, okay. No.
I'm trying to get the numbers back up, man.
No numbers are worth you saying hawk Tuah on this program. Okay.
I agree.
Hawk Tuah. If we're going to die, I'd rather die having not said hawk Tuah trying to survive, okay?
That's right. There you go. Okay. See, that's why Moulz is the captain, all right?
There will be no hawk Tuah.
Some things are still
as too long shameful. As I run the skate key. And I run the skate key.
The skate key. They don't know about it. Well, they know about that skate key. We didn't play songs from it. But anyway, yeah, good sample.
We're going to get into the history of it, at least, you know, the notable examples. It was flipped twice before Groupie Love.
Okay.
So the first would be on PMS by Mary J. Blige.
All right. Check it out, y'all.
From the No More Drama album.
Oh, for sure. Here we go.
Talk to the ladies tonight. Yeah. About the situation I'm pretty sure y'all would be able to relate to. Trust me. What's that? Today I'm not feeling pretty. See, I'm feeling quite ugly.
Mel in high school with them acne breakouts. Yeah, damn. All right, that was good.
So I already brought him up during the first track on here. I'm gonna have to bring him up again later. It's Talib Kweli, who has more connection to 50 Cent than some people would probably believe.
Okay.
When 50 Cent was the guest editor of XXL magazine, I believe in the summer of 2002, before Get Rich came out. Maybe it was the summer of 2003 at most. He was guest editor and he interviewed Kweli.
Oh, is that right?
I think he just wanted high tech. I think he wanted to rap on those beats Kweli was rapping on from high tech in them. So,
okay.
Yeah, this is Talib Kweli from the Quality album, which features the hit song Get By, produced by Kanye West. This is Good to You.
All right.
Yeah. Yeah. Come on.
Yo, hey yo, my silent moments, loud as the crack of thunder. My hunger like the crocodile that attacked the hunter. It ain't commercial or underground, it's true, cause I'm gonna be good. Call a skill, call a game, call a glow, call my name. Like the law, all the veins, screaming like you all in pain. Treat it like a drug, all up in your vein, cause yeah. We make the squares dance and get the dough like Dosey. Y'all niggas roll with pussy cats like Josie. All spoiled rotten like ghetto grocery, yo. I clutch the mic like the grandma clutch a rosary, yo. Swooping the industry like a bird of prey. My stance has got stamina, your verses lack vertebrae. I heard him say it
was... Okay. All
right. And now we're at Groupie Love, which is, funny enough, one of two times G-Unit sampled this being the first.
Okay. Well, check it out. So
yeah, G-Unit. Yeah. I've been so many places. I've seen so many faces. Girl, you look like someone that I done fucked before. I've been around the world. I met all kind of girls. Girl, you look like someone I done fucked on tour. Things change.
I'm rich, bitch.
You done heard of my name.
50 Cent, bitch.
I'm a P-I-M-P.
I'm a pimp, bitch.
You done heard about me.
I'm the shit. Yeah, things change. First they didn't want me, now they want me. See a nigga getting paid, they wanna push you on me. You see these hoes chasing a nigga. I have them in the hotel chasing a nigga. Treat me like a lollipop, lick me, baby. Then lick Dr. Dre and Shady. Oh!
All right, I'm just going to say it because it's in my notes. Ain't no licking Dr. Dre and Shady, okay? No, I know that they were popping, they're hot, they're famous.
Look,
but
he has a responsibility as well, you know?
Yeah, right. He has to report to, you know, the brain trust, but come on now. All right?
Do you see what I was saying about the tone in his voice, kind of like raspier than usual?
Yeah, perhaps. Yeah. Well, you know, he's been out with the groupies all night, and so, you know, he's...
This is what it's all about,
telling
man.
Jokes.
Look, this is at the hotel bar, Ric Flair, I'll have a couple of sea breezes.
Okay, fuck Ric Flair. Okay.
All right, telling them, woo!
I want 50 Cent to powerbomb Ric Flair onto a bar countertop. That's
I don't think 50 would powerbomb people just because he's not going to put another man's head between his legs.
He can do close to my dick, man.
Let me do a choke slam, man. Teach me how to do a choke slam.
Maybe I do a DET. Okay. No, he would do
I'm not doing a German suplex, man. All right. All he's got to do is bend over, man. And something else.
That makes sense. He's like Bully 50. He puts you in a headlock. And then he drives your head into the fucking... Yeah, okay. Yeah. That's his finish.
Oh, right? One of his signature moves? No, friends. It's like the belly to belly, like the hug. And it's like, he's hugging you? It's like, nah, he's slamming you.
Right. He's making you think like Buck, you know?
Yes.
He's making you think. Meanwhile, he's going to put the audio out and expose you. Okay? We know what's going on.
No pile drivers, no power bombs, no German suplexes. Okay.
And we could just be confused.
I know.
And then he hits you with that belly to belly right there. Okay.
Belly to belly is fine. German, uh-uh.
No, not having it. Not having it. Not having it.
You could do like the AA, you know, or the F5.
Oh, yeah, for sure. He loved the F5. Spin a nigga around. I just fall in the fucking mat like a pancake. Okay.
The spinner. That's like the G-Unit spinner, right?
All right. Yeah. Yeah.
The G-Unit spinner is just an F5. But like the old F5.
Right.
Like during his first run where he'd like kind of flatten you on the way down.
That's my F5 right there. Now they land on like their side, you know, which I
these F5s
safer.
Are fake as fuck now.
Okay. They're fake. They're fake. Okay.
They like free fall instead of falling like flat with impact.
He would flat, he'd press you down.
I miss the pre, like, the, it's like from his debut to when he wrestled Goldberg at WrestleMania and then he left the company. Then the new F5 is from when he came back. And I don't fuck with the new F5 that much.
Okay. He had two types. Just check, you know, shut your mouth for type one. Or here comes the pain, because it had both. It was either one where he just, like, flings you and just lets you fall where you
may. I'm a fan of the fling on, like, a Jeff Hardy type of guy or, like, a Spike Dudley.
Right.
But I like the flatten, like, on a Kurt Angle or The Rock. Or it's exactly. Like, wow, you know?
Because, like, they would, like, bounce off the mat. Like,
yeah, that's crazy.
After, yeah. It used to be better, you know?
Oh, man, he's such a bad guy.
Oh, right. Oh, see, I forgot.
He's such a bad guy. Like, we have bad guys, such bad guys, and terrible guys. And he's not quite in the Benoit category, but he's certainly not just a bad guy.
He's saved by the fact that he never got to be as bad of a guy as he was trying to be, you know?
Facts, yeah.
So,
but he's still a terrible, no, he's a very bad guy. He's not a terrible guy, but,
right,
you know. It is what it is.
That's what it is. Exactly. Here you go.
It's wrestling.
That is
dude, wrestling. I heard Hogan was being racist again.
Yeah. Did you see black this? Woman influencer that he partnered with or something. He found out she was a Blizzak Gizero and then canceled it.
And then hired something. White influencers instead.
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't know what he's doing.
I don't want to do promo with any nappy-headed hoes.
Actually, I do know what he's doing. He's racist, but...
Exactly.
I thought that era was I thought he wasn't gonna do shit like this anymore. I thought not that he learned his lesson, but he learned the consequences of behaving this way publicly.
You would think, but no, they never learn. They never learn. The most they can learn is to just not.
Well,
do
this
it
is like, you know, plausible deniability style. It's like, oh, I didn't get rid of her because she's black. She wasn't who I was looking for the part, brother. Like. She wasn't as qualified as the other people I found.
Well, the thing about Hulk Hogan, dude, is that I love women, brother. But she just had bad vibes, dude. It had nothing to do with her being a Blizzak Gizero. That's probably what he would try to tell us. And you know what? We would sit there and accept it because we're dirty fucking marks, okay? Is he a racist? Absolutely. Do I like when he rips his shirt and flexes and points? I do.
He has the best theme in the game. I mean,
real American, okay? We need this mythical real American now more than ever, but
he's just gonna be like, look, I'm not racist, dude. And Moulz and Mel are gonna be like, all right, I mean, he seems like he's not racist. He just told us he wasn't. These days people are so proud to be racist. I'm sure he'd just admit it if he was. Then we go Moulz back Mel, to
Moulz, Mel and Cash. Front row.
Oh, Moulz, Mel and Cash, arms locked together, okay. With our fucking Hulkamania shirts on.
Oh, shit. When it comes crashing down and it hurts inside, man.
When it comes catching down, okay?
Yeah, exactly. There you go.
We got more flips, though.
Yeah, Groupie Love, right. Okay.
So G-Unit sampled it again on the Body Snatchers mixtape. Revenge or Return of the Body Snatchers, we covered it. We've reviewed this tape before.
We did cover that.
It was the first of the This Is 50 mixtapes post G-Unit Radio. So, what do you give this one? What did I give it? Be good to me.
What season was this?
I don't know.
Season, I want to say it was like in the past 2 years. Let me see.
Season 12?
11. Let me check.
13?
12. And 12 mixtapes.
Feels like it would be season 13.
Season 12. It was season 12.
Season, okay, season 12.
Okay, let me see. We do so many of these episodes, folks, okay? Where is this? Be good to me. 7-. 7+ for you.
Okay. So I don't like it as much as Groupie Love, but I like it well enough.
I like it the same, apparently.
Yeah, so. We know. I mean, it ain't the same. You got to change your rating on the spot after you hear it. Be good to me and how it's not as good.
All right, well, here it is.
You gotta love me.
You got to be good to me.
Yeah, you gotta figure out how to make me feel special.
I'm gonna be good to you.
And I'll be good to you. I'll treat you the way you need to be treated.
You got to be good to me.
You gotta be all I need you to be, baby.
I'm gonna be good to you.
and I make you feel like, oh my God.
I'm a 360 nigga, 730 all the way dirty. I got that burner on me now, you heard me. Taste the good life twice, rap the shooting dice. Hell no, I ain't put my head between her legs. Smell a leather, feel the wood grain, bitch, I'm proud. And the bitch continental, see, bitch, I'm out. Got to wanna win like I wanna win and do things my way. If not, I'll put your ass out on the highway. I'm a bad judge of character, I know that shit. Man, time don't fly when you fuck with the wrong bitch. I mean, damn, why you come to me, bitch? What you want from me, bitch? You like the boogeyman, you're haunting me, bitch. I give you money, you spin that and come back. Like you need a new stack. I'm puzzled now, how the fuck you blow that? You got a nigga on the side.
That's right. I remember that. That's a good one.
Well, things started to get a little rocky after that because we entered the blog era, full stop, you know? You're already in the blog era with that mixtape, but it was 50, you know? He came from the mixtape era. Then, you know what happens. The trickle down of it all, okay? Asher Roth, ampersand, from the Paps and Jazz mixtape is next, okay?
All right, here we go.
If I gave you my love,
what the fuck?
Come on. Tell you what I do.
Yeah. Yo, you know this shit, I grow this shit. My modus operandi is devoted to the rhyming. Take the time out to remind them. Watch your hiney right behind you. Lions hide and strike in silence. I am giant, intertwined with Iron Mike and Kobe Bryant. Tying, reaching new heights. Now that I'm defying science, I provide entire slices. All depends how big my pie is, but I forgot the apricot. Gosh, I'm such a Roger Klutz. Knocking sake back, but not block out the opera.
You ain't like that Roger Klotz reference?
Roger Klutz is what
he said. He said Klutz. It's supposed to be Klotz.
No, he's trying to do a play on words. Like, I'm such a Roger Klutz.
Exactly. But
all right. No, that doesn't sound good to me. Okay. And it doesn't do anything for me. And it doesn't fill me with any sort of thoughts or anything like that. I'm just sitting there blank and waiting for it to end.
You know what? I'm about to say it.
You know I hate the blog era as well, but I didn't mind that. It's the degenerate blog era gene that's in me, you know.
He's doing the Asher Roth and applesauce flow, okay? I don't want to hear that.
You know, but...
What about French Montana? Come on out, you rapist!
Oh.
Okay? Soul food. This is from before he did the rape.
Okay. I mean, it's a fact. I'm not laughing at the act. I'm laughing at the phrasing.
Come on out, you rapist!
Okay, well, here it is, folks. It's French Montana, who is slow, I hear. He's a little slow.
Well, but... he has a bullet in his head that can't be removed, or it could kill him or make him more dumb, so they're just going to leave him.
Look, when it comes to people with metal in their head, he's second, and I'm putting Pete and Pete's mom at number one. So, yeah, here's Soul Food.
I'm gonna be good to you. I'm gonna be good to you.
La música de Harry Fry.
I'm gonna be good to you.
Holiday season, nickel.
I'm gonna be good to you. If I gave you my love, I'd tell you what I'd do. You got to be good to me. I'm gonna be good to you.
You know I'm trying to make it from the hundreds, crumbs, getting money high, come smoke that with try soak. Okay, my love, niggas scared to get a gun, get caught and do the Wayne. No, me, I do the same. Treat drama how I come, treat bitches how I want. Tell the baddest I'm the coldest. Treat me like a Moulz, hit the water, breaking down a quarter. I know we hurt more when you bleeding on the inside. Never love the money more, never hit your honey wrong. Another day, another day, another day, just another dollar. After tax, ashes to ashes, I'll play the bottom.
Okay.
It was better than Asher Roth.
Okay. You know. Where's my girl at? Okay, to that statement that you just made. All right.
There are multiple truths, you know.
There are multiple truths.
Okay.
There are multiple truths, okay. I would rather hear the guy who's kind of slow because he has a bullet stuck in his head than the guy who raps like Peter Rabbit, okay? It's just, it's simple. That's all. And now we're at the end of this little journey here. Kid Cudi, Living My Truth from the Intergalactic soundtrack, his anime on Netflix featuring my good, close personal friend Jaden Smith of Just Water fame. This is Living My Truth by the one and only, the incomparable Kid Cudi.
Oh, brother.
Light sprinkle for the mighty brain of nigga.
I like
when the girl is looking, please don't ask for pictures.
It's a
mission every day, just living on some scriptures. We forever,
know that
I won't miss you.
Uh-uh.
Turn it loud, it don't matter when and how.
It's cool.
I feel like graduated, time I take a bow.
Salute.
New adventures, we escaping with the crew.
As we do,
get all in it.
Uh-huh.
No more slacking.
One of the biggest scams in music ever, Kid Cudi. I just it's ridiculous. Yeah, listen,
Man on the Moon 2, The Legend of Mr. Rager review out now during this now. RAB Express season, okay.
Or the RAB Intermission. Yeah, we
done. Yeah, whatever. RAB Express, RAB Intermission. It's the same fucking thing.
Okay. Oh, it is? Okay. Listen, all I got to say is, man, I was so glad to hear Yayo. And this is how I felt, speaking of 03. Sub him in for Buck, because this is just like an NBA Live 03 when Samaki Walker was the starting power forward. And you had to, I personally would go into the rosters and make Robert Horry the starting power forward by default, because he should have been starting. But I guess this is a little different because Yayo, he had to be unlocked, literally. He was in jail.
It wasn't a decision, you know?
Right.
And I'll tell you, if he wasn't in jail, Buck would have been on the album less, because if you look at the mixtapes, Buck was not on those as much. Like, if you go song to song. You know, we know what it is. We know what the unit really is and who the unit is. All right? It's the three guys from Queens.
You know, I mean, Yayo is just so full of life and hits us with that sometimes.
He's so much more entertaining than Young Buck. That's why I find it funny when people tell me they prefer Young Buck to 50 Cent. Because it's like, all right, listen, maybe 50's not your cup of tea. You skipped over Lloyd Banks, who's easily the best lyricist of the crew, and you skipped over Yayo, as many people tend to do, one of the most underrated rappers of all time, and one of the most entertaining rappers of all time.
He's very entertaining, okay?
All right? Buck is, like, fourth, okay? No one cares.
You're telling me...
You're not cool or different for thinking that he's better than 50 Cent. You're just a mark and a hater.
Okay, don't be a contrario, okay?
That's contrario bullshit. That's what it is. It's contrario 101.
It is.
Get out of town with that nonsense, okay?
It's ridiculous.
And for all this talk about the West Coast is suffering, Butch Cassidy's great on here. He wasn't suffering. He was having a good time.
He was having a good time.
With the groupies.
With the groupies, exactly. And I'm going to tell you, Yayo gave us poetry with, listen, young and old, these hoes is loose. Wintertime's the staircase, summertime's the roof. Come on. Come on.
Is that Walt Whitman or Tony Yayo? That's what I ask. Okay?
You know, Icy Neck was on the tour bus, ass naked. That's hilarious. And hey, listen, one of the few, well, not few, the whole industry fucking knew, but he called him out. You want that R. Kelly shit? Your bitch is barely grown.
Jay was doing albums with R. Kelly still at this time.
Yeah.
The Best of Both Worlds Part 2 hadn't come out yet.
Okay. Yeah. Fucking, we know. All right. And yeah, Banks on cleanup on his player shit. He's being brash. The song calls for it, you know.
He knows how to play that role.
That's right.
You know, as a lyricist, he's not just that. He can sub in and do this kind of player shit if needed.
Yeah. And he's hitting us with those, you know, those Banks punchlines, those mixtape. I'm in your bedroom fucking up your sheets like the Ku Klux Klan. I pop.
You got to love the Banks mixtape punchlines on here. They ground the record as a whole.
Yeah. You know?
As a whole. Like, I mean, all the songs where he does shit like that on it, that's what we want. We want classic. For this era, we want the classic, like, punchlines and fly player bars from Banks. The completely brash and ridiculous and over the top bars from Yayo, and 50 to just be that you know, like the backbone of it all, to be the center.
Right. That's right. Okay. That's the trio we know and love.
We discussed this dynamic in depth many times. That's right. And when we get this original dynamic, like, to me, this is a really good album, possibly a great album. You know, but
possibly
it's not my ideal configuration. Get Yayo off that brick wall and put Banks. I'm sorry. Put Buck on the fucking wall. OK,
I have to agree with you.
And he did invent Yeezus, because who put their face on the wall first? Kanye or Yayo?
Wow.
Yayo and with this album, between, you know, the glitching at the end of My Buddy from 50. We got, you know, Yayo on the brick wall, and you saw how he was projecting the New Slaves video. I mean, I think we cracked the case. Jesus is a G-Unit Records Kanye album. He took all of the cues he learned from 50 told me, go ahead, switch your style up.
Right.
He told him. Right. He even said that. Yeah. I have audio of Kanye saying that, so you want to know something, too. Him switching his style up to even do Yeezus was a 50 Cent influence move.
Wow. Listen, folks, 9/11/07. The answers all come from that day.
The truth is out there.
It's out there. All right. We know.
I know that you need to be, as the audience, you can't receive all of the information at once. It has to be doled out little by little, so you absorb every piece of information. And, you know, you see not just the error in your ways, potentially, if you were one of those people who voted for graduation that day, but maybe you weren't. Maybe you feel vindicated, but with new information, even more solidified in your beliefs, you know, which is always good.
Look, all I can say is that some have whispered that we're currently living through another 9/11 type event.
9/11/07, let's be
right,
clear.
9/11/07 event in Hib. I'm just hearing whispers that it's currently happening. I don't know where, what it involves. It's just what I've heard. So make the right decision is all I can say. You got anything else?
Well, in this case, there is no right decision, but I don't have the time to get into that. And we've already.
Well, I wouldn't know. I'm just saying, this is what I've heard. I don't even know what the matchup is. I'm just saying, you know, 9/11/07, a lot of people made the wrong choice.
I don't believe this is 9. I don't believe this is 9/11/07. It might be for you personally.
Me? I told you. I don't even know. I've just heard these things. I don't even know what they're referring to.
I don't think it's going to affect larger change overall. But like I said, you really don't want to get me started on this one, okay?
Oh, listen, listen.
Best of love. We got to move on, though, okay?
Fair enough. We'll move on.
Oh, fuck me. I just made the whole connection. This about to get so depressing.
Fuck did that come from? Yeah, let's just move on.
Hey, it's Mel from Rap Rankings. To hear the full episode this clip comes from and all of the other episodes, check the link in the description, stop by raprankings.com, or search Rap Rankings on your favorite podcast platform. And please consider liking, subscribing, and commenting to help us grow the channel and continue our journey as hip-hop's first and premier extreme podcast.